Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Well, we are going to discover how to play Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures on PC. Here you are able to display it on screen. It takes almost no time to simply download and install Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures and enjoy playing your game on the Windows desktop or laptop using our keyboard, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's get to it. First of all mates, to start we have to open our main browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's go to that URL I'm highlighting in green. Now, you are able to see on the screen. You don't need to type this URL, simply because I added a clickable link in the description of this video in the first main comment. After clicking on the link, we get to the website of LDPlayer. No panic, it is just the Android emulator that we are going to use to get access to the game Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures on PC. As you can discover from here, we get a number of pros of preferring using the emulator, custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. Then, we will start downloading the Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures by clicking on the button Download Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures on PC that you can see here in green. Next step is clicking on this button. And the download takes no time at all. Here it is, this is the download. It is an executable file. What we are going to do is to run the installer, so we have to click on the file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to make modifications to the computer. We have said yes. I reduce the browser to start to see the installer much better. The installer is really easy to understand. It is made up of two options, install, and setup path. I will explain what setup path really does. We simply click it. Therefore we observe that we display here the path where the emulator will be placed. If we want to change this directory we have got to click on that browse option, and now we opt for another folder and install the emulator exactly where we prefer. To keep it simple, just set it where it is. I simply click back. So I simply click on install. At this point, before beginning setting up that emulator, it is possible that it's going to show us a number of software deals to put on the laptop. Since I do not want to have any of these computer software, I purely press each time on the reject option. Voila! The installation commences and it's going to proceed along with the download of these megabytes that are represented on our computer screen. Once you save it on your machine, it might possibly be more or less megabytes. The download rate can be at a higher speed or at a lower speed, subject to your web access and according to the performance of the emulator web servers. Now they are working really fast. The download is finished, and so instantly it continues with the installation part. The installation will require more or less time based on the strength of your laptop or computer. The more powerful it's actually, the faster the setup time and vice versa. If we integrate the download and software setup stage it normally takes a very long time, so be patient. It is by now ended for me. At this point, the emulator has been started immediately. As you will notice, down here, we have a progress bar that will advance to the right then when it reaches the end, the emulator will be started for the first time. The fact is the emulator was already started, here for the first time. Plus LD Store is immediately started, that is a kind of Google Play. It is not the most correct method to install the video game, and so I will not suggest it, considering the fact that possibly the LD Store installs an out-of-date version of the Android game. I am about to assist you the right way to set up the game working with the Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we are required to begin doing is to navigate to the desktop by simply clicking on this icon that I am pointing out in green color. Before we carry on, as you can observe, it created two icons there on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon is the one we're concerned with. Anytime we need to start Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures on our PC, we twice mouse click on that app icon and consequently launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer icon is not related to multiplayer or nearly anything like that, indeed, it is an app icon that we would most certainly never utilize. We should perform the next phase, that is a must, and which is to access the Google Play Store. To do that we will go here to, System Apps, we click. And we'll simply click on Play Store. As you can see now the Google Play is launched. In this case we must sign in. At present as soon as we're there, we must conduct the next step which is imperative. Therefore just click on, Sign In. At this point it says, Checking Info. It might in some cases get stuck in, Checking Info, additionally it does not move ahead. If that's the case, you could attempt to log in after a few hours and it will surely probably be repaired. At this point we will type our username and password. The email address must be a Gmail email and its matching password. As an example you can utilize the same email you're using at this time in your YouTube account. So that I will submit my details and I'll come back after I have completed it. That's all, details typed. And here is Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We will accept all of them by just pressing I agree. After that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You could leave it selected and it will produce a backup of your data files on that device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. From now Google Play is launched as preferred choice and immediately. If the Google Play just isn't launched automatically and you do not know how to run it by yourself, I share with you how to get it done. The crucial element is to proceed to the emulator desktop by hitting this icon noted in green color. At this time we go to the System Apps folder. And we click the Play Store icon. Okay, we're right within Google Play. What we're going to perform now is go here to search for apps and games. Then we are going to research Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures. Now there we have it, we should click on the first result. Right here we get the Android game. Let's quickly click right here on the install button that I'm highlighting now in green color. Therefore it will begin the software setup. At present it will download on your laptop or computer and install the game. It may take quite some time or perhaps it may just be extremely fast. It again all is subject to on our web connection. This has by then ended setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by hitting the following button that I am showing in green, in order to launch Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures for the first time. We're by then on the emulator desktop, then we're going to simply click this new Barbie Dreamhouse Adventures icon that was provided. This video game is started for the first time. There we end up with it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I should comment on the sound level of this emulator. It is right here. We have the icon of higher volume and the icon of lower volume. This way we do not use the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the greatest, we could turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. That is the very first one, we mouse click on this app icon that I am actually pointing out in green color. Then take full advantage of your monitor, having one border at the top, one at the right and the last one at the bottom. Supposing that we really want to launch the video game in full screen, we mouse click on this app icon. And we'd without a doubt be experiencing the game in 100% screen mode. To leave the full screen setting, just click the F11 key. And therefore we would likely just end up being in normal display mode. At this moment I am starting to clarify you the computer keyboard mapping which is definitely very appealing. This strategy we definitely will be in a position to utilize the game application far more easily. The first task is to press this software icon. And here you will be able to complete the required configurations. I can leave the default configuration, however if you intend to adjust it, you may very well do this without any problem. I have this chance to say that occasionally, when starting the Android game a black screen appears, if this is like that and you get the black display and the emulator is unable to launch, I comment a achievable fix. We should browse here, to the cogwheel. Within the emulator options, in the advanced selection we get several screen resolutions. This is the resolution that we have at this time opted for as favorite choice and we must choose any of these additional image resolutions, for example this particular one here. We pick it and consequently click on save. It will tell us to restart the emulator and once rebooted, likely the emulator will launch and the black display screen will go away completely. Obviously, the emulator is totally in our own language. Occasionally it happens that your emulator is launched in the wrong language, for example, in Japanese. Then to set it in the appropriate language we go here to the cogwheel. Then here throughout additional settings, we click the language drop down. We can decide on the language we want, Italian, Mandarin, and so on. Once the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator would restart, and also the game application, next time we use it, will also be in the picked language. At present, there's another point that we will need to take into account, and this is that we will receive an email saying that a completely new electronic device has been associated with our Google account. It will definitely check with us if we are the ones who have associated with that electronic device. Yup, we may not be troubled, since the emulator is acting as an Android smartphone or tablet. And then to discover which tablet or smartphone is being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we just click on it. So we go here to the model selection. And right here we see that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cell phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all folks, so much for my training. I hope you appreciated it, especially that you found it informative. If that is so, allow it a great thumb up, subscribe, and if you have comments, issues or ideas, put them in the comment area down below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams on occasion, you have it below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Click on any of those video tutorials which are usually showing up on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the upcoming video game videos. Bye.